Welcome to the Developer Basics. In this first hour, we're going to be covering getting started. What is getting started? Getting started basically enables us to check and see all the most important foundations and keys and things that are relevant to us to know before we could actually start learning how to code. By the end of this hour, you should know a few things. One of them is knowing your Flash environment. Knowing your Flash environment. Basically, there's a lot of things to cover in knowing the Flash environment, but we're going to cover the basic things that you need to know, such as knowing what the property panel is, the toolbar a bit, the timeline a bit, comparing between different versions of Flash. We're not going to focus on the platform too much. What we're going to do is show you all the different keys and important things to notice and where to find things. Another topic that we're going to cover is files. We're going to look at the different versions of files that we're going to be working with. We're going to look at source files, we're going to look at deploy files, and we're going to see the differences between them. And a topic that connects directly into that is publishing. We're going to look into how to publish files, the basics, the core foundations of how to publish, what is publishing, what files are created when we are publishing. The next topic, which is a very, very important topic, is in the next 11 hours, we're going to be using mainly that output panel. So we're going to look into what the output panel is and how to work with the output panel. And to top that off, we're also going to look a little bit into troubleshooting and understanding when things go wrong. At this stage, it's early on, but just to know whenever we have an issue so we'll know how to solve it. The next topic, which is really the root of all the topics, the intro, all this is going into OOP, object-oriented programming. Even though in this first 11 hours in the developer basics, we're not really doing any object-oriented programming, we're deliberately teaching in a way which will make it much easier to understand object-oriented programming when you complete the series. Now, object-oriented programming, with that said, you don't have to work in object-oriented programming. You could still work in the timeline. So if you have experience with the timeline or you prefer working with the timeline, we're going to show you the two different variations, even though we're going to pick and ideally try to work mainly with object-oriented programming, which means working with classes, and we're going to look into what that is. We're going to top that all off with our samples, looking at how do samples work, and we're only going to cover this once. Every course, every hour that goes by, we're going to stop saying a few things, and slowly, slowly, courses are going to get harder and harder. How do you make sure that you're with us and you're not getting lost in the crowd, right? So first of all, you might, before you even get to that, you might be thinking, well, I know a little bit about the Flash environment, I know what the output is, or maybe I know what I've read about, I've done a little bit of timeline coding. That's all fine, but I still encourage you, and obviously it's a little bit hard to watch a whole hour of video if you already know some of the material. And because of that, we developed a tool to make it easier at everythingfla.com. You have to be a registered user there. And after you are a subscriber, you could take part in our exams. And when you take an exam, what does that enable you? When you take an exam, and I encourage you to take an exam before you do anything else. When you take an exam, even before you watch the videos, even if you never worked with Flash before, right after you take an exam, it gives you a score. Not only does it give you a score, it breaks down your score based on the videos and enables you then to only watch the videos that you don't know. So if intuitively you know some things, or if you have some experience, just by taking the exam, you can then filter out all the things that we think you already know. I encourage you not to continue on before you have a score that's greater than 80, greater or equal to 80. For you to pass an exam, you have to have a score that's greater or equal to 80, and all these stuff happen only on everythingfla.com. Obviously, we have a support team, and you can always contact us at support@everythingfla.com. We have a community, and it's growing and getting more vibrant as time goes by. Encourage you, connect with our community. Our community is a very, very important part of our site. And as always, go on to everythingfla.com, everythingfla.com, everythingfla.com. Even if you're not watching this on our site, very, very critical. Our whole structure of teaching is really, really dependent on the fact that you're taking the exams and you're progressing video by video, knowing which one is the next video you should watch, and making sure you don't have to watch things that you don't really need to watch.